Confused about the cosmos? Can't tell a planet from a star? Then give us just 5 minutes, and we'll show you what they are. Jack Horkheimer, Stargazer, tells you all about the night sky and the biggest show of all, the universe. And now, this week's episode.
A Lunar Liaison with Leo the Lion. Greetings, fellow stargazers. I'm James Alberry from the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium at Santa Fe College in Gainesville, Florida, and I'll be your sky guide this month on Stargazer. This Independence Day, you'll get to see the moon have a close encounter with the heart of Leo the Lion, and you'll get to see a pair of stars whose names are a tantalizing tongue twister. Wondering what I'm talking about? Here, let me show you. Alrighty, I've set our sky to just after sunset facing west. Close to the horizon, you'll see a thin, barely 5-day-old crescent moon. Take a look just to the upper right of the moon, and you'll see the bright star Regulus. Regulus is the brightest star in the constellation Leo the Lion, and in Latin, the name Regulus means prince or little king. This is quite appropriate since this star marks the heart of the celestial king of the beasts. Leo's easy to find in the spring and early summer sky. Just use the Big Dipper. Look at the two stars of the Big Dipper's bowl that are the pointer stars, Dubhe and Merak. Those are the familiar stars you use to find the North Star. Then take the opposite stars, Fecta and Megrez, and go in the opposite direction, and you'll land smack dab on Regulus. Regulus is actually a multiple star system with 4 stars orbiting in pairs. This stellar ballet is happening over 78 light years away, so when you look at Regulus, you're actually looking at it the way it appeared back in 1933. Another interesting thing about Regulus is that in Arabic it was named Kalb al-Asad, which translates as the heart of the lion. During this particular lunar liaison, Regulus is just a mere 5 degrees away from the moon, or 10 full moon widths. So it should provide a very pretty display. So while you're outside watching the 4th of July fireworks, take a look over to the west and check out the moon's close approach to Regulus, the heart of Leo the lion. Now, if you look to the south at the same time, you'll see our old friend Scorpius the Scorpion. He looks like a giant letter J in the sky, where the bright red supergiant star Antares marks his heart. His claws on current star charts are here and here. But did you know that the Scorpion's claws were once much longer than they are now? On older star charts, approximately 2,000 years ago, the Scorpion's claws extended upwards to the stars Zubin al-Shamali and Zubin al-Ghanoubi. In Arabic, Zubin al-Shamali means northern claw, and Zubin al-Ghanoubi means southern claw. These two stars are now part of the constellation Libra the Scales, the only constellation in the zodiac that is not a living creature. And if you're familiar with your Latin, zodiac means circle of animals. So why is Libra part of the zodiac? Here, let me show you. As we travel around the sun during the course of the year, the sun appears to move against the background stars, slowly drifting eastward along the constellations of the zodiac. 3,000 years ago, the autumnal equinox in the northern hemisphere occurred when the sun was among the stars Zubin al-Shamali and Zubin al-Ghanoubi. It is believed that ancient astronomers made a correlation between the appearance of the sun in this part of the sky with the equinox, which means equal night, because near the equinox, day and night appear to be equally long, 12 hours of daylight and 12 hours of darkness. Libra, being the constellation of the scales, represented balance and equality. So it only seemed fitting to take the stars in this region and associate them with the constellation that reflects such balance. Sadly, in creating this new constellation, our old friend the dreaded Scorpion got his claws clipped. The neat thing, though, is that they kept the names of the stars the same so that we'd always know that the Scorpion once had a more menacing manus. Alrighty, well, out under the stars with you, and remember, my friends, whatever you do, keep looking up.
Make the Stars Your Own is available on DVD or VHS for $19.95. In addition, Stargazing with Jack Horkheimer, Cosmic Comics for the Skywatcher, is also available for $19.95.